today. From U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, this is the National Football League.
Snowfall is forecasted to hit the Twin Cities, but right now, calm outside, and of course, a calm day inside U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. The scene a short time ago, this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with the Dallas Cowboys. For the first time, they'll be led out by their quarterback, standing 6'3 out of SMU. It's Garrett Gilbert.
I read something prepping for this game that he said prior to, and I think he really said it a few months ago, where he talked about he wants to have the type of season that at the end he's buying gifts for all the guys who helped him along the way. And I know that the team wants to hold him to that and really get into his wallet. But that's what good leadership gives you. You know, at the end of the season, because you've done a great job, QB, he's usually the guy who springs for the good stuff.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
That was a pretty good job defensively to hold them to a 2-yard run, but I've got to think this offensive line, they're asking their quarterback for a different type of a run, one that they rely on, one they have confidence in, one they feel like they can block.
From the 27, Gilbert. That's complete to Dalton Schultz. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. Yeah, Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. Strong start by this defense. 3rd and short, they go with a run. Stonewalled for no gain.
I played for a guy who always talked about setting tones and meeting force with force. That felt like it on that play, didn't it? And they met it in a big way and won. What a great job by the defense.
Comes the Cowboys punter, KJ Osborne, deep for Minnesota. A 41-yard punt there with no return, and the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. The Vikings ready to go to work, led out by their quarterback in his 3rd year wearing purple, 9th year overall. In the NFL, a Pro Bowler in Kirk Cousins.
The debate about Kirk Cousins continues to rage both among Vikings fans and fans around the league. But when you look at his numbers, you think this is one of the better quarterbacks in the league. Last year broke a string of four straight 4,000-yard passing years with the emergence of Dalvin Cook in the backfield. So while those numbers dropped, he was still solid throwing the football. 26 touchdown passes, just 6 interceptions. Now he's just got to develop an extra target on the perimeter in order to get his numbers back to the previous levels.
Cook with a run on first down, but he'll only manage a couple there before he's taken down.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Cousins gives way to Cook, and not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sip through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. On 3rd down, Cousins. Across the 40-yard line. He'll get 15 and a Vikings first down.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Down, here's the run with Cook. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. From the gun, here's Cousins. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 43. It's a first down on a gain of 10. So from Cowboy territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 43. Now Cook. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
From the 39-yard line, here comes 2nd down at 6. Working out of the gun, Cousins. He gets it left side to Johnson. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's 3 catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. 3 catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter. And he will be very close to a 1st down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be 4th down in a few inches.
They tried their best to pick up that 3rd and 1, but their surge wasn't enough to counteract what came back at them from the defensive side, was it?
Offensive line, especially in the middle, looked like they were on skates a little bit when that one started.
So now we bring up 4th and inches. This would be a critical call.
So they'll say no to the 50-yard field goal try. Instead, the offense out there, they're going for it. Running for it, here's Cook. Good spot on the field to go for it. Kind of no man's land, as they call it, and it worked out.
Yeah, they call it no man's land because your punter is telling you it's too short. I'm just going to punt it into the end zone. Your field goal kicker might give you a little raised eyebrow. Might be too far for the field goal. So it gives you a great chance to go for it. Personally, If you have those tendencies to be aggressive as a head coach, you kind of like this spot because it gives you the decision to go ahead and go for it when you want to anyway.
And throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And it's brought down after a very nice gain. A gain of 32 that time.
Well, that's something that this defense is not going to be able to allow if they're going to have success here. They've got to be able to wrap up and get guys on the ground. They end up letting him get away, and it turns into a big play here early on. I can just see veteran observers of the game shaking their heads and talking about the dearth of tackling in the game today.
They need about the length of the football here on first and goal. They'll run for it with Cook. And he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. Delvin Cook taking it in. And the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead. And Charles, he's able to dive in there in a short yardage situation.
Just find a place to get to the end zone. Didn't matter where it was, but once he did, used his nose for the end zone and dove in.
Dan Bailey now for the extra point. He's got it, and the Vikings take a 7-0 lead. They have the short field, and they make quick work of it. Just two plays to get into the end zone. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards, the loss, 2nd and 12. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. Off play action, Gilbert. Gonna take a shot for Gallup. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. On that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Operating from the gun, Gilbert. And he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a 4th down.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, what we're watching offensively, A little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive, looking at another one here. Just a little slow. And, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it, any team we cover always talks about a
fast
start.
That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they're going to have to figure it out as this game moves on.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Cousins to throw it. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 11 yards there, first down.
We often talk about understanding the playbook, understanding progressions, and understanding what the defense is doing. We saw all of that on that play. Great recognition and understood where his running back was going to be. Found a way to have him leak out underneath. Hit him with the football, and they picked up the first down.
Cousins on first down. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Play fake. Cousins. And he's got the hook up here. It's Kyle Rudolph. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 23 yards the pickup there.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. They'll run on first down. It's Cook. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Tackle there by Leighton Vander Esch.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that this defense has done as good of a job on him as they have on any runner in recent memory. Chains. Let's go! Let's go!
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. To throw is Cousins. This is caught, and he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Another good completion on the drive as the Vikings have a first down. They've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. They'll run with Cook. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. So stuffed from the 2, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Trying the power game with him. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Minnesota. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage. And that's why you have the fullback, Charles. Couldn't get it into play before with a smaller guy. Turned to a little more power. They score.
And that has to warm the hearts of a lot of old-school football fans. They love when they get to see a little bit of power football.
Here's Bailey now for the extra point. Kick it away after the touchdown. Now Pollard. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Dallas offense back out onto the field.
And this is their third drive. Maybe the focus right now, not so much on points, but getting their first down.
And when you start off a game, you don't even think that's an issue, do you? But you go a drive, a second drive, no first down, that becomes an issue. Now you got to think about, okay, what type of play calling do I have to do to get us in a spot to pick that first one up?
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32.
Well, that kind of run on first down, that's a winning type of a run. That just sets things up for them moving forward as they begin the drive.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. From the gun, Gilbert. Intercepted. The rookie Jeff Gladney picks it.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. We're in the 2nd quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, try to get him more involved here on this drive, maybe. throwing the interception. Cousins. And complete right side to Cook. Not much there, only a yard. Second and 9 from the 44. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. The Vikings on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Here's Cousins. Him in stride. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. Catch number 4 for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On 1st and 10, Cousins. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. Coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coaches. 2-minute drill.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a first down on a gain of 10. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles. All passes, all completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
This will be caught at about the 6. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
2nd and 4, they could still get a first down without scoring. He's going to get this one down to Cook, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. They'll run it. Here's Cook. Now he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. Delvin Cook with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Extra point try by Bailey. And it is now 21-0. So that guy takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it's capped off by a touchdown run coming from Dalvin Cook.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Now Pollard. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. In the second quarter, they're down big already. He's struggling as well. They've got to find something here. He's got to find something on this drive.
And sometimes you take on all that extra pressure on yourself, and maybe you have to disperse it a little bit. Lean on some other people. Lean on your teammates. Find someone who can take the pressure off and get the ball in their hands for a while.
Or this, if he doesn't, this is getting out of hand, or it could get worse. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Four receivers in the formation here. Three to the left, one to the right. Second and three. Operating from the gun. Gilbert. It'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. First down, Gilbert. He'll go underneath here to Elliott. And a well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
And I don't think there's any question that this offense is going to need to hit on a few more plays like this. It's been a difficult first half for them, to say the least. And I do believe if they want to get back in this game, they need to start right now. It's kind of like making adjustments. If you try to wait until the half, it's probably too late. They need to get going right here.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. Zerline's kick is up and through. And the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. Now K.J. Osborne. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Reason to do anything foolish as they'll snap it one more time on first down. He'll take the knee and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. It was a strong first half for the veteran quarterback, Kirk Cousins. His guys have the lead, as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half. And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback. Dalvin Cook taking the field for the Vikings' next possession.
And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it three times.
And you got to figure from the defensive perspective, how has he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a third time? How do we tighten things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they're really in sync right now.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Starting the third quarter with Cook. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
And it's pretty evident when you watch how Minnesota plays, just how important Dalvin Cook is to their offense. A 1,000-yard rusher a year before, the first one the Vikings had since Adrian Peterson was dominating their carries. And having Cook in the lineup for the bulk of the season, that made Minnesota exactly what their head coach Mike Zimmer wanted them to be, a much more physical team that complemented their defense.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. Throwing is Cousins. And complete, right side, the tight end Rudolph. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 10 yards, and it's good for a Viking first down.
Well, partner's a pretty easy explanation for his success in this one. He's very comfortable throwing the football. Did you just see that one? In the pocket, no real pressure, yet to be sacked today. When he's that comfortable, that leads to those types of completions.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Cousins. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Johnson. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Here on fourth and inches.
I'll bet they thought they had picked that one up because it was a 3rd and 2 call. And they got awfully close. Now we're at 4th and inches. I wonder if they think they're feeling lucky here and maybe want to go pick it up.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. And Charles, they trail by 3 scores. Look, they're not completely out of this, but it's sort of go time right now.
Yeah, and they knew that coming out after halftime, it was going to take a collective effort to get back into this ball game. The defense got the stop for them, so maybe that can get things started. Now the offense has to pick their game up as well, and if they can put a score on the board, hey, they could get back in it in a hurry.
Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. Gilbert. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on 1st down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Off the play fake. Gilbert. He'll fire this deep for Gallup. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A big play here for Dallas. 48 yards. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well and get a few stops.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. From the gun, Gilbert. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott. That'll bring up second down.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. From the shotgun, again to Elliott. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. He'll be brought down at the 21 after a pickup of four.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. This is Elliott.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. Operating from the gun, Gilbert. This Minnesota D up to the task on the third down pass play. And that one off the mark, a little late with a throw. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And that'll get the deficit down to 15. So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points, able to give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
After the made field goal, Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. And able to get this out to the 25.
Oh yeah, boy, oh yeah.
The Vikings head out to take over once again. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun. Looking for Thielen. That's intercepted. Picked up by Leighton
going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. He's got it. They're back within a score. It's 8-21-13. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And this will come out to the 25 as Osborne elects not to return it. Minnesota now ready for their next possession. They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down a bit.
And probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively. Because a lot of times we think it's just play calls and this isn't working and they're shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for here.
Trying to get that edge back as they've watched this lead shrink a little. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Now that's a run that warms a play caller's heart because you're actually set up to do whatever you want on offense. You can come right back and run essentially the same play because you have momentum, or you can fake that running play and throw something deep over the top, or you now feel like you have an extra down to play with because if you go ahead and just throw it and you don't get it, come back and try and pick it up on third down.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
I'm getting a sense that the momentum of this game is changing since the break. Nice play there, and this D is fired up.
Behind the chain, 2nd and 12. Cousins. Little pitch and catch here to Rudolph. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up 3rd down.
So a 3rd and 10, and defensively, a dime look. 6 DBs. From the gun, here's Cousins. Gets there this time for the sack. The take, DeMarcus Lawrence with a sack.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense, 6 defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline, they keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. give him three on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
They'll try and get the running game going with Elliott. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. He was brought down by Eric Wilson.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Side, and he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A gain of 13. It's a first down. Nothing flashy there. The slant to the slot.
Oh, and the frustration for the defensive guys, because it's a quick play, and you know it's going to be a bang bang play in terms of the throw and the catch, and then he's able to absorb the contact to complete it.
A first down carry by Elliott. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Field strike, they look to throw. And he can't escape, and down he goes. And after the sack, he's still down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Cowboys on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 19. From the gun, Gilbert. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He'll get 17 back there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right, Gab. A guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
No returning this one. It sails out of bounds and they'll spot it right at the 20. And now out comes Minnesota. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Out of the gun, he'll throw. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. How good has he been throwing the football, though? And despite that incompletion, that's just the third time he's been off target this entire game.
And Brandon, I've been on the other side of this equation, trying to defend a guy who's been this hot. And it chips away at your confidence. And when you're not confident when you're trying to defend, it makes you slower to the football and at least more completions for them.
Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
On third down, Cousins. That is incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for Minnesota. Called for and made it about the 32-yard line. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. Well, the defense got its job done, forcing the punt. Now the formula pretty simple. They need to find the end zone here. A field goal doesn't help them much. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Gilbert. Flag for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked away in the cues. Well, that puts a little bit of a wrinkle in their comeback bid.
Yeah, everything had turned around for them, hadn't it? I mean, things were now going their way. But you did mention it's a wrinkle in their comeback bid. It's not the death knell for them by any stretch, but now they've got some extra work to do in order to climb all the way back.
Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 44. He'll start by handing it off to Dalvin Cook. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one. And it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Working out of the gun, Cousins. And he's got this down to the 35. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
Another nice pick up through the air. And I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon. But with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now Cousins. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Cousins gives way to Cook. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The Vikings on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is 3rd and 8. So they got traffic there, and that's complete. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 24-yard line. Cousins to his tight end, Rudolph, for a Viking first down.
He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
First down, here's the run with Cook. Great move, but still wrangled before reaching the 20. Tackle made there by Chidobe Awuzie.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They run it again with Cook. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Now what a first down pickup of eight. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a three and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. To throw, Cousins. And he's wrapped up. Taken down, back at the 25. Off the edge, it's Tyrone Crawford with a sack.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. Well executed there on second down, so do you go back to the air on third?
Well, that's a possibility, but now you've opened up things to where you showed that you would run the ball in long-distance situation. You might come back again because I doubt they believe you'll do it a second time.
Cousins from the gun on third. Oh, no, he lost the football, and the Cowboys have recovered.
Team football gets tested a little bit because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden they heard the sudden change call because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Following the fumble recovery, Gilbert. He finds his target. It's Schultz. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and they're going to have a third down.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down.
Saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
First down now, but that clock rolling. He's back to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Schultz. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
The Cowboys looking to get going again in a hurry. Throw left side complete. It's Elliott. It's a gain of 5, and it'll be second down.
And remember, field goal does them no good in this situation.
You got to think they should be taking some shots for the end zone soon. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Working with second and 5 now. They'll look to throw. This one incomplete. Too much contact to run out of that one, and it's third down.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And a crusher there as it's intercepted. The rookie Jeff Gladney picks it. And they'll have the football but deep in their own territory as he's brought down at the 5.
Well, they needed the touchdown and the 2-point conversion, but they're not going to get a shot at either. This is a great play here defensively, Brandon, and at a time that they sorely needed one. And that could be enough to help get them out of here with a victory.
Minnesota now ready for their next possession. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
Start the drive with Cook. And he'll just plow right into a host of tacklers. Nothing there at all, and it'll be second and 10. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Again, it's Cook. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. And when people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. They'll keep it on the ground. Cook. And they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line. 13 yards on the pickup, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
seconds have ticked away in this Minnesota victory, and it was a bit of a strange game. They were held scoreless through the entire second half, but their first half output, that's enough to carry them to victory.
And that's an odd game to watch, isn't it? Because when we saw the output in the first half, you think to yourself, okay, they've got something working here. They know what they're doing. They'll continue that along. But instead, it's goose eggs in the second half. Fortunately, enough of a cushion and enough defense to carry them home.
For us, for Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. It's a win for the Vikings as we say so long from Minneapolis.